details about the structure of the Vedic universe, a little bit more about cosmology. In his purport to verse 23:43, describing the traveling of Kardama Muni, Prabhupada, he gives a lot of detail about the structure of the universe according to the Vedas. So he says that, quote, all the planets are here described as gola, round. Every planet is round, and each planet is a different shelter, just like islands in the great ocean. Planets are sometimes called dvīpa or varṣa. This art planet is called Bhārata-varṣa because it was ruled by King Bharata. Another significant word used in this verse is basu ascharyam, many wonderful things. This indicates that the different planets are distributed all over the universe in the eight directions, and each and every one of them is wonderful in itself. Each planet has its particular climatic influences and particular types of inhabitants and is completely equipped with everything, including the beauty of the seasons. In the Brahma Samhita 5:40, it is similarly stated, Vibhuti Binam, on each and every planet there are different opulences. It cannot be expected that one planet is exactly like another. By God's grace, by nature's law, each and every planet is made differently and has different wonderful features, right? Unquote. So that's Prabhupada. So from here, we get the following pieces of information that you can also see on the slide. So first point, although the different planets, they are often called dvipa, island, or varsa. Varsa means tract of land. They are actually spheres floating in space. So the usage of the word dvipa or island is thus metaphorical, like it alludes to the fact that planets are like islands floating in the ocean of space, right? This is what Prabhupada mentioned in his purport. So then B, the term Bharata-varṣa refers to our planet, which was ruled by King Bharat, right? That's the second point. Then third point, planets are distributed all over the universe, and each planet is different from each other, from the other, right? And it has particular opulences and different types of inhabitants. So each planet is like unique. Each planet has, however, conditions that are specially tailored, specially created by the necessities of the people who live there. And it, in this sense, each planet is complete because it includes everything necessary for their maintenance, right? So then there are some extra points here from a different source. So in his famous letter to Swarupa Damodara, and that's from a letter from 1977, Prabhupada gives his final conclusions about the cosmological model offered in the Vedas, right? That was one of the last statements of Prabhupada on the topic. That's from 1977. That's from the end of his presence in the world. So there in this letter, Prabhupada adds four more details. So one, the universe is like a tree, right? With the roots upwards, and the different planets and stars fixed in their respective orbits, right? So the universe is like an inverted tree, and the planets and universes, they are and the planets and stars, they are fixed in different parts of this tree, and the whole thing is moving. Everything has certain orbits around Dhruva Loka. So second point, there are different paths leading from one planet to another. Some of them are made of gold, others of copper, etc. These pathways they allow interplanetary travel. And these paths, they're like the branches of the tree, right? So you have like the tree with different leaves and fruits, and then you have these paths connecting the different planets that are just like the branches of the tree, going in all directions, interconnecting everything. And then third point, the whole tree with all the planets and stars rotates around the pole star, right? Dhruva Loka, every 24 hours. And this results in the passage of days and nights. So days and nights are because the whole universe is rotating around Dhruva Loka. Simultaneously, the sun has its particular orbit, going up and down, because the sun goes like this, right? So it goes up and down, north and south in the sky. And this results in the passage of the seasons. So this is the final conclusions of Prabhupada about the structure of the Vedic universe. He didn't say anything different after that.